Welcome back to another Sunday walk video. Man, I don't know what happened yesterday. I have no idea. It's one of those WTF moments. I'm hearing things as they're coming along, being reported. So I got to talk about today what happened yesterday with Trump and that assassination attempt and how that's going to affect things going forward, especially when it comes to crypto. And of course, we got to talk about Bitcoin. Bitcoin's doing much better today. And is that a forecast of what's to come for this week? Let me discuss that as well. All right. So as for what happened yesterday, I mean, I think everyone is just shocked as I am. Whether you like the guy or not, we haven't seen assassination attempts since the 80s, I believe, with Reagan. That's what I heard. I don't even remember it because I was too young back then. Like, it's just something that you just don't hear about anymore, right? It's like this day and age with all the technology that we have, you just figure when presidents and presidential elections, or presidential candidates, I should say, have their rallies, you just figure it's gotta be safe. There's no way an active shooter or a sniper can get a shot off, right? Well, yesterday proved that theory to be wrong. There's a lot of theories out there, okay? So I'm not gonna try to contribute to them because we're getting bits and pieces of information, right? And we just don't know what's actually true and what's not. First of all, where the shooter was on top of this rooftop seemed to be very, very close to the stage, and like people could literally see it, right? It wasn't like a mile away or 2 miles away. It was just several hundred feet away. And there were reports about how people on the ground saw the shooter, even tried to report it ahead of time, and nothing was being done. And also Secret Service, you know, they had snipers also on the roof, adjoining rooftops. And it almost seemed like they saw it too. They saw it before it happened. So, I mean, there's a lot of wild things, wild speculations about what may have occurred, why this wasn't stopped beforehand, right? Like, how are they not prepared for this? You got to figure where they held the stage and the rally, like where they held it. They must have, like, you know, secured the buildings around, blocked them off. I mean, I'm assuming everyone in attendance were searched. I mean, plus all the security and again the technology. I'm sure they have cameras everywhere and stuff. How is this missed? I have no idea. I really don't. But here's the thing. We had it, and now the country is wondering. This is the big narrative, right? The country is wondering how this happened, and what is Trump going to do? Well, it seems like he's going to press forward. Seems like he is unfazed by this, because he's supposed to be going to the Bitcoin 2024 conference in next week. Actually, next week, to speak about Bitcoin. And I'm told that he's not canceling that. I thought he would for sure, but I'm told that he's not. That he's going to be appearing. And that's crazy. That's crazy. And I can only imagine the turnout that he's going to be bringing to Nashville and the Bitcoin conference. It's going to be wild. It's going to be absolutely wild. Anyways, I don't want to add to the theories, right? There's a lot of theories out there that this was an inside job. This is a Secret Service they're doing. You know, maybe this is one party that wants to, you know, take out the other. I'm not going to add to that. I just, as an American living in the U.S. for many, many decades, I haven't seen this before. And it's just shocking that it can still happen in the United States even today, right? Just, it's really crazy. No matter what our beliefs are, right? It should never come down to this. This is just going overboard. And this is something that I hope we never, ever, ever see again in our lifetimes. Yeah, that's that. But like I said, I'm looking forward to seeing him in the Bitcoin conference. I wonder what he's going to say. Trump obviously has turned pro crypto, pro Bitcoin. And is that going to be good? Is that going to be good for Bitcoin crypto? Yeah, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Maybe nothing gets done if he gets elected again, but hey, having a pro crypto leader is better than a non-pro crypto leader. I'll say that. And we have seen many politicians, many Congress people, even agencies, you know, turn pro. I'd say CFTC is pretty pro with their stance, saying that 70 to 80% of all crypto are not securities. I think that's a pretty pro statement. You know, a lot of politicians are coming out defending the miners, the Bitcoin miners, and of course, Bitcoin itself, and recognizing the self, the importance of self-custody. Even one of the governors, I forgot which one, even said that after learning more about money and Bitcoin, he wants to propose a ban of the Federal Reserve. I'd say we've come very far. Very far. We've never seen these things happen before in previous cycles. So this is definitely a move in the right direction. And part of the maturity that people talk about, right? You know, there's a lot of buzzwords, a lot of parables that gets thrown out there. People always say maturity of the market. What does that mean? Well, I think this is what it means, right? Basically, adoption, general acceptance of a new asset class, Bitcoin. So, all good. Now, as for Bitcoin's price, at the time of this recording, it's at $61,000. That's pretty good. Pretty good. On Saturday, when I streamed, we were still about 58.8. Prior in the week, we were like 56, 57. You know, it got a little dicey. A lot of bears came out because of Germany, Mt. Gox, Genesis. You got like a whole bunch of FUD. The thing is, what did I tell you guys? We'll get through it. We always do. It always seems worse than it is. So now that Germany's completely done, that's 3 billion plus. That's eaten up, right? 3 billion plus that we don't have to worry about being sold anymore. Again, that shows you how strong the market is. The market ate it up like it's nothing. And plus, we still have Mt. Gox, who have already started distributing. And some of those creditors sold off. Some didn't. But even with them, right, you mix them in there. And then you mix miner capitulation, right, which means that miners have been selling off. But I mean, it's all looking like it's getting better. Right, it's getting better. Now Genesis, still a wild card out there. They got 2 billion plus. Are they gonna be dumping soon? Who knows? What I do know is it's all gonna be eaten up. Okay, Wall Street, they don't have enough. Larry Fink, he certainly doesn't have enough. Wall Street ETFs took in about $1 billion, okay, this last week alone. So all the billions that we keep throwing out there, Genesis has 2.2 billion, right? Mt. Gox, I don't know how many billions that they have. They're all short-term distractions. That's what they are. Because when Wall Street's buying by $1 billion per week, it's all gonna be eaten up. In 52 weeks, that's 52 billion. And we know that there are weeks that's more than a billion. there will be days that will bring over a billion. Just think about that. There will be days in the future, in the near future, where Wall Street takes in more than $1 billion worth of Bitcoin per day. That is a certainty. So all this FUD right now, it sucks. But the best way to think about it is you have more time to DCA. You're given this golden opportunity to buy more, to buy the dip, right? And that's fantastic. We know Bitcoin and entire crypto market cap is going to go higher. So why would you not view our current situation as an opportunity, right? Buying Bitcoin below 60 is a gift. It's a gift, especially when we see 70 soon, 80s, 90s, 100. And then I'll point back and say, hey, do you remember those two discs that we had that brought us into the 50s? Did you take advantage? Or did you start some FUD and you panic sold, right? So it's living through these moments that really tests your conviction and faith in Bitcoin and your character, right? A lot of people say a lot of pro things when things are going right, but do they say those things when things are not? That's the key. That's what you guys need to focus on, right? In a bull market, everyone looks like a genius. Everyone starts throwing out crazy predictions and a lot of them are right. And people follow them. But then when things turn sour, those guys turn sour, and then you're left not wondering what to do. You're left wondering if you should have followed those guys in the first place. You guys know my stance. I've been through many, many cycles. I've been through many hardships, many black swan events. And one thing that I always stress is don't rush it. Have patience, because almost everyone coming into this space rushes, okay? Even I did, and sometimes I still do. I'm not perfect. I still fall for my emotions. Sometimes I want to FOMO. Sometimes I want to panic sell, right? I still get those feelings. But the one thing, if there's nothing else I've learned, the one thing I did learn is you got to have patience. Sometimes you got to hold on something for years. Years. Okay? But you're rewarded handsomely for doing so. That's the bottom line. Sometimes when you rush, you try to outsmart the market, you try to outtrade the market, thinking that you're smarter than everyone else, that's when you lose. Sometimes lose massively. Or sometimes you don't even realize you're losing. But in the end, you calculate things and you realize you are. So don't be one of those people. This week, I believe, based on how this weekend has been going, could be quite positive, right? Of course, it doesn't have to be. Of course, maybe Genesis starts selling or more Mt. Gox FUD comes out and causes the market to go down. But, you know, I think based on Germany and based on Wall Street from last week, I think this week could be absolutely fantastic. And the fact that Trump confirmed he's going to Bitcoin conference, I don't know if it's 100%. I take that back. I don't know if he himself has come out, but I've seen reports that he is still going to be attending. But I think this week, next week, leading up, because we only got one more week, 2 weeks until the Bitcoin conference. So I think we could see a pretty good rally. We're sitting at 61,000. The next resistance is 63.7. That was one that was a resistance turn support. Unfortunately, we lost that support. So now that will be the next test. I think with all the shorts that are piled on right now, just a little bit of momentum will liquidate them and drive us much higher. So I think 63.7, we could see that. By the time I stream tomorrow, we could see that already. But I think we're going to hit that soon. The question is, after we hit that, are we going to get those short squeezes and drive us up back to some of the previous levels, like, of course, 65, 68, 70, 73. we get a tremendous push this week leading into next week, leading into the Bitcoin conference, and we actually shatter our previous high, which can be possible. It's not outrageous to think that if we have a solid momentum this week, next week, we can definitely get back to 73,000, and we could possibly start the conference at 75 or a little bit higher, 78. It's not out of the realm of possibility. That's for sure. You could say it's planned. You could say it's manipulation. It's whale games, whatever you want to call it. But hey, if it's to the upside, I don't really mind. Do you? Right? If we're going to get some whale games or some kind of push up to high for the conference, I welcome that. I welcome that a lot. And I think most of you guys do too. So that's it, guys. Let's see what happens this week. I'm thinking it's going to be bullish. I'm thinking it's going to be real bullish. And as for the whole assassination thing, I don't know. I hope this brings people closer, not farther. There seems to be such a great divide between the two sides now, and everything is a political debate. I don't know how this happened or when it started happening, but I hope we never see something like this ever happen again in our lifetimes. And I hope that we can come together and move forward. That's it. Smash the like, subscribe to the channel. I'll see you guys tomorrow, usual time, 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time. Take care. Bye-bye.